Today, let's talk about the best support loadout that you've probably never heard of. When you think about a support loadout, you probably think of an LMG paired with an RPG, just to suppress fire and to perhaps take out vehicles. But you certainly don't think of the M13, but if you stick with me, you may end up seeing why I think this is the best support loadout that you could be running. In my previous videos, I've talked about the M13 and given you a few builds for long range and medium range, and they're pretty good. But we're gonna take that medium range M13 and we'll turn it into something that will have every squad wanting one on their team. In this build, we'll be using the Tempest Cyclone Barrel, the TAC Laser, a medium range optic of your choice, 60 round mags, and star of the show, Concussive Grenade Launcher. But pretty much, you'll want irons or a reflex sight for lower FOV, and if you're on higher FOV, you'll want the AIMOP reflex or a holographic sight. When you first grab your loadout, you only get one grenade, but it's enough to get you a free kill. When used defensively in a 1v1, there's really nothing the enemy can do, and it's just a free kill. It's cheesy as hell and really unfair, but thankfully this is not the way that it should be used. This build is best used when you use it like it should be, asserting your dominance at medium range. However, when your team gets outnumbered or there's just a situation where you guys are just in a really bad spot, you can use the grenade launcher to turn the tables. In this clip right here, would we have been able to survive a 3v2 without the grenade launcher? Probably. But would we have been able to do it without losing any plates? I don't know about that. Unlike normal stun grenades, the grenade launchers activate on impact. So if someone's holding an angle, they won't have enough time to run to cover. And while they'll still be holding that angle, you now will have a better chance. Just note though, there is a slight delay before you can switch back to your normal weapon. So if you stun someone and they're right in your face, you may have to melee them. And that's another reason why this build is best used as a team. And while it's definitely possible to take on teams by yourself with this, there eventually will come a time where you need to plate up or reload. Especially since the M13 eats ammo really fast and basically has only enough ammo to take out two people. Now you're probably thinking, what's the difference stat-wise between this and the medium range build we had before? Its damage and recoil are pretty much the same, so we'll ignore those. So for its mobility, its ADS time is 15 milliseconds more, its ADS stray speed is 0.3 meters per second less, and its sprint out and attack sprint out time has taken a pretty big hit, so it's less effective at closer range, but you do have that grenade launcher to compensate for that. And its stability is much better now, so you can stretch this out to even further ranges. Of course, that does mean you do have the TAC laser, so if you are pre-aiming a door, everyone will know exactly where you are. Everything else though stays the same. And now you may be thinking, not bad. Can I try this on other guns? Well, not really. Initially, I wanted to do this on the Kilo, not the M13. But the problem was that it just wasn't that effective at longer ranges. With the suppressed barrel, its recoil is a bit harder to control than the M13's, and while its TTK up close is better, it's just not worth it when you start stretching ranges. And for the M4, its suppressed barrel is really bad. Don't even think about using it. The reason the M13's build works so well is because despite it only having a pretty average TTK up close and at range, it does have an amazing ADS time and mobility, meaning that you can get the jump on people even when you aren't concussing them. And if you're fully plated, there's a higher chance of you being able to take down the enemy that has already fired upon you first. So is this a broken and OP build? No, not really, but it will help your team and it will let you run stuns and a heartbeat sensor at the same time. Just make sure to find an ammo box and use it in order to replenish those grenades. And maybe get some of your teammates to carry some as well instead of dead silence. You know, as a thank you for saving them those plates. But that's the build. What do you think about it? And would you run it? Or do you wish someone would use it on your squad? If there's any topics, questions, or ideas you want me to cover, just leave them in the comments here or on Instagram, and you may see them on the next Community Wednesday. And that's the video. If you enjoyed it or it helped you in any way, please hit like. If you got any questions or comments, leave them down in the comment section down below. And if you want to make sure that you never miss another video, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.